The National Health Policy recommends that a general hospital should serve a population of at least 500,000, a health center for at least people, and a health center to a population of 5,000. But the remote Kalangala district, which has a population of over 50,000, offers a stark contrast. The health sector at the 64 habitable islands of Kalangala is ailing as the sick remain trapped, often without transport to access better medical care. Esther Nanyonjo Chiza, a resident of Banda Island in Bufumbira sub-county, Kalangala district, is one of the mothers who have been trapped due to lack of medical services. Nanyonjo narrates how she lost her 5 months pregnancy in a boat to Kalangala Health Center for. One of the most challenging encounters I have ever experienced here at Banda happened last year, where I had no capacity to get a boat that would rush me to any health facility while in pain. A good Samaritan availed transport to me up to Kalangala Health Center for. Sadly, I experienced a miscarriage before reaching the facility. The island lacks a nearby health facility and it requires 150,000 for one to get to the government facility on Bufumbira Island, which most mothers can't afford. Although the government allocated a water ambulance to Kalangala district for emergency responses, Nanyonjo says she has never seen it. I have never seen the ambulance, but I heard people talk about it. All I know is that there is a road ambulance that transports us from Mwena landing site to Kalangala Health Center 4, then to Masaka. One of the consequences of a miscarriage is death of mothers. On Banda Island, two mothers lost lives after failure to reach health facilities on time. Currently, the area legislator Moses Kabosu is constructing a health facility on Chitobo Island near Banda Island. However, residents suggest that the best way to improve on the health status is availing speedy boats with enough fuel. To date, it's still a building under construction, but when it's turned into a health facility, it will be of help. Residents also believe the facility will not only improve service delivery, but also end absenteeism of students on Chitobo Island, as Vincent Luhura states.
We shall have been helped as a school as far as our children are concerned, and the absenteeism will also reduce.
Majority of island women say men abandon them after conceiving, and this has forced them to engage in risk activities to make ends meet, hence losing their pregnancies. Report compiled by Samuel Nkuba for the news.